Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome back to another ATP video. So today we'll be talking about Mycoplasma pneumoniae. It's a very important bug that is commonly tested in exams and in labs as well. To start with, mycoplasmas are a very special group of bacteria characterized by their very small size and lacking of a cell wall. Of course, there are many mycoplasma species, but in this video we'll be focusing on Mycoplasma pneumoniae. Let us begin by talking about the features of this organism. As we've just mentioned, mycoplasmas are considered to be among the smallest free living organisms. Their most striking feature is the absence of a cell wall made of peptidoglycan. Consequently, they're not seen on gram stain, and antibiotics that are commonly used to inhibit the bacterial cell wall synthesis, such as penicillins and cephalosporins, are considered ineffective for this family of bacteria. Mycoplasmas are pleomorphic, meaning that they can assume a variety of shapes because of their flexible cell membrane. Another characteristic of their membrane is that it's the only bacterial membrane that contains cholesterol. Mycoplasma pneumoniae attaches itself to the respiratory epithelium by using specific proteins, thus causing local disruption of tissue and cell structure. And just like other pathogens, Mycoplasma pneumoniae produces its unique virulence factors that aids in its pathogenic pathways. First of all, it produces CARDS toxin, which is known as community-acquired respiratory distress syndrome toxin. The CARDS toxin aids in the colonization of Mycoplasma pneumoniae, leading to inflammation and airway dysfunction. Secondly, it produces hydrogen peroxide, which contributes to the damage to the respiratory tract cells. Mycoplasma pneumoniae is transmitted from person to person through respiratory droplets, and it's the classic cause of walking pneumonia, which is a non-medical term for pneumonia that is not severe enough to require bed rest or hospitalization. The disease occurs frequently in young adults, military recruits, prisons, and colleges, where people spend a lot of time together in each other's close quarters. The onset of symptoms is gradual, typically beginning with a non-productive cough and sore throat. Small amounts of whitish, non-bloody sputum are also produced. Constitutional symptoms of fever, headache, malaise, and myalgias are pronounced. Chest x-rays of these patients show patchy or diffuse interstitial infiltrate, and it's noteworthy to mention that the x-ray usually looks worse than the patients themselves. Mycoplasma pneumoniae is the most common type of atypical pneumonia that was formerly called primary atypical pneumonia. And when we say atypical, it means that the causative bacterium cannot be isolated on routine media or that the disease does not resemble your regular pneumococcal pneumonia. We've mentioned earlier in this video that walking pneumonia is a milder form of pneumonia. Hence, the disease usually resolves spontaneously in 10 to 14 days. In addition to pneumonia, the organism can also cause extrapulmonary manifestations, which include Stevens-Johnson syndrome, myocarditis, autoimmune hemolytic anemia, erythema multiforme, Raynaud's phenomenon, and others. How can we diagnose this type of bacterium? Usually, when we hear the word bacterium, we immediately think of culturing as a diagnostic tool. However, diagnosis of mycoplasma is usually not made by culturing, as it takes at least 1 week for colonies to appear on special media known as Eaton agar. Their colony has a characteristic fried egg shape, with a raised center and a thinner outer edge. Cold agglutinin is another fast serological test that can detect the presence of IgM autoantibodies against RBCs in the patient's serum. However, only half of patients with Mycoplasma pneumoniae will be positive for cold agglutinins. Thus, the test is non-specific and false positive results can even occur. Remember, you cough in cold with Mycoplasma pneumoniae. So this is the equivalent to pneumonia, cold agglutinins, and IgM. Under serology, we can also use enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay, ELISA for short, as a diagnostic tool. Lastly, polymerase chain reaction, PCR for short, is considered as a great tool to diagnose this bug. It's quite important to know about the characteristics of the causative organism as it will affect the treatment regimen. Remember that mycoplasmas are wall-less organisms, so antibiotics such as penicillins and cephalosporins will be useless. So, what other options do we have? We have macrolides such as erythromycin or azithromycin, or tetracyclines such as doxycycline. The fluoroquinolone levofloxacin is also effective. These drugs can only shorten the duration of symptoms, although as mentioned earlier, the disease resolves by itself spontaneously within 10 to 14 days. Now we've discussed everything about Mycoplasma pneumoniae, so what are the available preventive measures against this organism? Unfortunately, there are no specific preventive measures and no vaccines are available at the present time. However, just like many respiratory germs, the spread of Mycoplasma pneumoniae infection can be prevented by simple measures such as covering the mouth and nose during coughing or sneezing, and frequently washing the hands with soap and water. Alright, to sum up, today we've talked about Mycoplasma pneumoniae. We've said that it's an extremely small organism characterized by the absence of a cell wall. It primarily causes atypical pneumonia, which is the most common cause of pneumonia in young adults. It's also responsible for outbreaks in groups with close contacts, such as families and military personnel. It can be identified with PCR, culturing on eaten agar, and high serum titer of cold agglutinins. Treatment choices include macrolides, doxycycline, or fluoroquinolone. Penicillins and cephalosporins are ineffective. Why? Because Mycoplasma does not have a cell wall. And that's it for Mycoplasma pneumonia. We hope you found it beneficial. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to receive our latest updates. And as always, thanks for watching.